Kashi Misra Bhavan, the house of Kashi Misra Prabhu. Kashi Misra Prabhu was the spiritual master of Maharaj Pataparudra, and he used to come to this place to have the darshan of his Gurudev, massage the lotus feet of his Gurudev. And Kashi Misra was very, very merciful to Pataparudra Maharaj. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted sannyas and then came from Navadvip to Puri, at first he stayed in the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya for a short time, then he went for a tour of South India. So when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya told King Pataparudra Maharaj, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu needs a very good place, which is at once close to the Jagannath temple and at the same time very secluded, a secret place where he can do bhajan. So Pataparudra Maharaj said, oh, my Gurudev's place is most suitable. And therefore the arrangement was made. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back from his tour of South India, then he stayed here in Kashi Misra Bhavan. So many devotees have taken darshan of this small room that is called Gambira. So Gurudev explained Gambira means gufa. One very secret small cave. It's so small, it's not easy to stand up or even lie down to rest in there. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he spent 18 years in this place, Sri Gambira. 24 years. But then he came back here. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in Gambira, there he tasted the Gambir Bhav. Gambir means very secret and confidential. So in Gambira, he tasted Gambir Bhav of Srimati Radhika. Srimati Radhika's Mahabhav has many Anubhavs. Rudha, Adirudha, Modan, Mohan, Madan, Chitra Jalpa, Divyanmad. So all of these moods, they have not been clearly described in Shastra. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he personally relished them and demonstrated them in his own behavior. Sometimes Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Gambira, and inside Shankar Pandits would stay inside to protect him, because due to his mood sometimes he would rub his face against the walls. Govinda would be outside and other devotees, they would be there to protect Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All the doors, there were three doors, entrances, they were locked. But somehow or other, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would disappear and all the devotees would be very concerned and they would search for him everywhere. Searching for him here and there, sometimes they would find him unconscious in Jagannath Vallabh Bhatika, the garden of Jagannath Dev. Sometimes Mahaprabhu would fall into the ocean and he would float for hours and hours, all day and night in the ocean, until he was caught in the net of a fisherman near Chakratirtha. Sometimes his body would become like a tortoise with all the limbs absorbed inside, and sometimes all his joints would become loose and his body would become very long. When the devotees would find Mahaprabhu, they would do kirtan and he would come back into sense. He would say, oh, I heard the sound of Krishna's flute, and hearing this sound, I ran to meet with him. And there I saw Radha and Krishna and gopis singing, dancing and performing pastimes together. So Krishna, he was very eager to understand the moods of Srimati Radhika. As Swarup Damodar Goswami revealed, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kirtishovana Eva. Krishna wanted to know how deep is the prema of Srimati Radhika. What sweetness does she taste in myself? And when she tastes my sweetness, what happiness does she feel? Krishna is very eager to know all of these things. But without taking shelter of Shiksha Guru, then it was not possible. So he stayed here in Gambira and in the company of Lalita and Vishakha. in the form of Roy Amananda and Saurabh Damodar. He took Shiksha in the mood of Radhika from them, and he fulfilled his desires to understand the Mahabhava of Srimati Radhika. So in this place, Sri Gambira, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he used to relish the writings of Vidyapati, Chandidas, Bilva Mangal Thakur's Krishna Kanamritam, Sri Jayadeva Goswami's Gita Govinda, the verses of Sri Roy Ramananda's Jagannath Vallabh Natakam, and the verses of Sri Srimad Bhagavatam, such as Brahmar Gita. Srila Gurudev gave example how Radhika, being fainted and unconscious in Vrindavan, when Krishna left and went to Mathura, at that time, Jayati Priyasangama, she was meditating, "Oh, I know Krishna, he cannot be even one moment without the association of some lover. So now he's in Mathura and he must be meeting with someone else." Then when she came into sense, she saw a bumblebee and began to chastise the bumblebee. "Madhupakita babando maskushangrim sapatnya. I know that you are a messenger of that cheetah Krishna. So don't try to touch my feet. Get out from here. Go and pacify his new beloved. I don't have any relationship with him anymore." Here Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would relish the verses of Gita Govinda. "Jahi madhava jahi keshava mahabhadakaita babadam." How Krishna, Radhika, would go into man and accuse Krishna of meeting with others, and due to the powerful influence of Prem, send him away, even though she was very eager to meet with him. So we're very fortunate to come to this place, Sri Kashi Mishra Bhavan, where the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, himself relished the internal moods of Srimati Radhika, very privately and very secretly, in this room, Sri Gambira. Sri Kashi Mishra Bhavan ki jai.
यहाँ पर महाप्रभु जी क्या के सब रत्न जैसे पंडित लोग अद्वैताचार्य नित्यानंद प्रभु शारदम भट्टाचार्य गदाधर पंडित स्वरूप दामोदर राय रामानंद और बड़े बड़े विद्वान दिग्गज महाप्रभु के अंतरंग सब लोग यहाँ पर उपस्थित होते दिन में और यहाँ पर उनकी हरि कथाएं होती। एक बार वल्लभाचार्य जी सारे भारत वर्ष में दिग्विजय करते हुए और उनका अभिषेक स्वर्ण अभिषेक हुआ था विद्यानगर में और वहां से यहाँ आए तो उनको अभिमान था कि हमने वो श्रीमद् भागवत पर एक टीका लिखी है शुभोदयनी उसमें सिद्धार्थ जी के विचारों का भी हमने खंडन किया है। एक समय आए और वो अपना भाष्य वो टीका दिखलाना चाहते थे शुभोदयनी तो उन्होंने कहा कि हम सिद्धार्थ जी के विचारों से सहमत नहीं है उनका हमने खंडन किया तो महाप्रभु जी ने उनको बड़े गंभीर होकर के कहा कि स्वामी के जे ना माने ताके बेस्या करी मैंने और चुप हो गए। उनके गंभीर भावों को सुनकर के बड़े लज्जित हुए। एक बार और आए अपनी विद्वता दिखलाने के लिए तो उन्होंने कहा हम कृष्ण नाम का अर्थ क्या है बहुत से अर्थ हैं कृष्ण नाम के तो आप बतलाइए। महाप्रभु ने ये कहा कि कृष्ण शब्द का एक ही अर्थ हम जानते हैं ब्रजेंद्र नंदन यशोदा नंदन बस इसके अतिरिक्त हम कोई नहीं जानते। इस बार भी लज्जित हो गए जब उनका जब बड़े बड़े विद्वानों को देखा अद्वैताचार्य जी को समस्त ये सब बड़े बड़े विद्वानों को देखा सार्वभौम भट्टाचार्य महाप्रभु जी ने कहा इनसे तो मैं सीखता हूं अद्वैताचार्य और सब कितने बड़े विद्वान थे अद्वैताचार्य भी साधारण नहीं स्वरूप दामोदर राय रामानंद इत्यादि जब तक स्वरूप दामोदर परीक्षा नहीं करते तो कोई कविता इधर उधर की जदवा तदवा नहीं ले सकता था नहीं तो महाप्रभु जी को बहुत कष्ट होता था पहले उनको सुना करके लाते थे। ये सब चीजें यहाँ पर सारी पड़ी हैं यहाँ पर यदि लिखा जाए बड़ी पुस्तक भी हो जाएगी शोध ग्रंथ। तो संक्षेप में हम लोगों ने कहा हियर ऑल द ज्यूवेल्स परिकर ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु यूज्ड टू गैदर हियर अद्वैत आचार्य ऑफ लर्नेड पर्सन ऑल क्वालिफाइड दर वाज नो अदर इनकी तुलना नहीं थी कंपेरेबल बिकॉज एंड दे ऑल यूज टू सीट हियर एंड टू डिस्कस सो मेनी थिंग्स अबाउट द रूप बुक ललित माधव विदक ऑल्सो ऑन द प्लेस ऑफ हरिदास ठाकुर एंड ऑल यूज टू कम वंस पल्लवाचार्य He conquered whole India and in Vidyanagar he was given Abhishek and then he came here and he was very proud that I have done a Tika, commentary of Srimad Bhagavatam Subodhini and I have repeated Siddharaswami, the commentary of Siddharaswami. Mahaprabhu became very grave. And he told, those who don't accept Siddhar Goswami's Tika, they are like prostitutes. And then he became ashamed. Sometimes he used to come and want to show his ability and glory. And he used to tell that, I know so many meaning of Krishna. May I tell, Mahaprabhu told that, I don't want to hear. I know that only the meaning of Krishna is Brajendanandan, Yashodanandan, Shamsunda, Radha, Kanta, Radha, Vallabh, only this, nothing else. So when he used to come with proud, Mahaprabhu rejected him. But when he knew, saw Advaita Acharya, Sarvampanta Acharya and all others, Swarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, especially a young devotee, Rupa and Sanatana, and he became very Then he knew that, my pride is false. And then he surrendered. And he wanted to take Gopal Bhante. Vallabhacharya was worshipper of Bal Gopal, Vatsalya Bhav. But here he saw, and he was changed. Totally. And then Mahaprabhu ordered, anyhow, Gadadhar Pandit to give him Gopal. And he gave him. Thus his proud went down, and then Mahaprabhu became merciful. Gaur Pramanande!
देते और यहाँ से कुछ देर बैठ करके बातचीत करते वार्तालाप इत्यादि होता हरि कथाएं होती। इसके बाद में महाप्रभु गंभीरा में जाते और प्रतिदिन उनके सेवक गोविंद यहाँ हरिदास ठाकुर जी के लिए प्रसाद देते थे। इस प्रकार से हरिदास ठाकुर जी यहाँ भजन करते थे तो ये समय से चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी मंगला दर्शन करने के लिए गए जगन्नाथ मंदिर में। तब वहाँ के पुजारियों ने एक सिद्ध भक्ति बकुल यानी मौलश्री के एक दाल जो कि दातुन के रूप में जगन्नाथ जी को समर्पण किया था वो विशेष व्यक्ति को किसी को भी प्रसादी के रूप में दिया करते हैं। तो महाप्रभु जी को जबकि ये दातुन दिया उस समय महाप्रभु जी आए और इसी स्थान पर इस दातुन को गाड़ दिया था तो उसी से ये वृक्ष बन गया जो कि बकुल का मौलश्री का पेड़ बना है। आज भी वो वंश वर्ष का निदान है, निदर्शन के रूप में स्मृति के रूप में विद्यमान है जो कि कभी रथ यात्रा में जगन्नाथ जी के रथ बनाने के लिए इस पेड़ को काटने का निश्चय किया था। तो उस समय वैष्णव लोग दुखी हुए, रात उस पेड़ में ही कुछ बदल गया। दूसरे दिन सूरज पे लोग आए आकर के देखा कि एकदम फबोला बना हुआ है, अंदर में कोई भी तथ्य नहीं, सारा लकड़ी खत्म, केवल छिलके के ऊपर आज भी वे वृक्ष खड़े हैं, इसलिए इसका नाम पड़ गया है सिद्ध गोकुल। श्री हरिदास ठाकुर जी यहाँ पर भजन करते थे। तो उस समय श्री सनातन गोस्वामी पा श्री रूप गोस्वामी पा यहाँ उनके पास में आ करके यहीं पर निवास करते थे। यहीं पर श्री रूप गोस्वामी पा जबकि उन्होंने ललित माधव नाटक को लिखा था तो लिख करके रास्ते में चलते हुए आ रहे थे। तो उस समय सत्यभामापुर में श्री सत्यभामा देवी ने भी उन्हें आदेश दिया था ब्रजलीला और द्वारका लीला दोनों को पृथक पृथक करके रचना करने का है। तो उन्होंने ही दो रूप में बना करके उस ग्रंथ को बनाया, यहाँ पर ले आए। उनके कुछ प्रस्तुत श्लोक जो पांडुलिपि के रूप में उन्होंने यहाँ जो कुटिया थी उसके अंदर में वहाँ कुछ श्लोक ऐसे लगा दिए थे। तो उस समय एक दिन महाप्रभु जी दर्शन करने आए, यहाँ आकर के जब बैठे तो रूप गोस्वामी जी स्नान करने गए थे। तो उस समय महाप्रभु जी का नजर ऊपर चाल में चला गया, देखा कि वहाँ पर कोई कुछ लिखा हुआ रखा है तो उतार लिए। उतार करके जैसे ही पढ़ा कि अनार पिता चरिम चिरा करुणया बती न कलौ यस्तु जब कुमार हर बनस्ता ये वही चैत्र सभा ये श्लोक। तब इस श्लोक को देख करके बोले अरे मेरे मन की भावना को कौन समझ दिया, ये किसने लिखा। अच्छा प्रिय स्वयं कृष्ण सहचरी कुरुक्षेत्र मिलित ये श्लोक को उन्होंने लिखा। तो महाप्रभु जी ये सुन दे करके बड़े आश्चर्य में आ गए कि अरे मेरे मन की भावना को ये कैसे जान लिया और कैसे लिखा। तो उस समय महाप्रभु जी चुपचाप रहे हैं, गंभीर रहे हैं। इतने में श्री रूप गोस्वामी जी स्नान करके जब लौटे उस समय महाप्रभु जी जैसे ही श्री रूप गोस्वामी जी आ करके सामने महाप्रभु जी को प्रणाम करने लगे, इतने में महाप्रभु जी उठ करके ये थप्पड़ लगाया पीठ पर, बोले अरे तुमने ये श्लोक कैसे लिख लिया, ये दुहार को कैसे समझ लिया, हमारे मन की भावना को कैसे समझा, तो क्या लिखा है, कौन तुमने बताया, किसी ने नहीं। तो शरद दामोदर जी से उन्हें प्राप्त हुआ था और फिर महाप्रभु जी की कृपा से ही जो कि उनको स्मृति हुई उसी तरह से जो कौर श्लोक के अनुरूप महाप्रभु जी के भाव के इस श्लोक को जो कि कुरुक्षेत्र विरह प्रसंग में जहाँ कुरुक्षेत्र में गोपियां कृष्ण से मिलती हैं तो उस समय का जो भाव है ये सारे भाव का एक श्लोक लिखा। तो उस समय महाप्रभु जी ने पूछा कि और तुमने क्या लिखा, तो बहुत प्रसन्न हुए। उस समय उन्होंने सुन लिया कि इन्होंने ललित माधव विदग्ध माधव नाटक लिखा है। ये सब सुन करके महाप्रभु जी बड़े प्रसन्न हुए। तो अब दूसरे दिन महाप्रभु जी ने सभी भक्तों को बुला करके मंदिर में दर्शन करते हुए यहाँ आए। यहाँ आकर के जब बैठे स्वरूप दामोदर राय रमानंद आदि जितने भी महाप्रभु जी के प्रिय परिकर सार्वभौम भट्टाचार्य श्री अद्वैताचार्य आदि से लेकर के समस्त बड़े बड़े जितने भी भक्त वृंद हैं सभी यहाँ पर बैठे। उस समय महाप्रभु जी ने आदेश दिया, श्रीरू तुमने जो श्लोक लिखा है वो बताओ और कौन सा ग्रंथ लिखा है, क्या क्या है। तो उस समय बोलने में संकोच में पड़े हैं, बोलना नहीं चाह रहे हैं। इतने में रायानंद जी ने श्री रूप गोस्वामी जी को पूछा, तब उन्होंने बताना शुरू किया, अनर्पित चरेम चिरा करुणया बतीर न करो समर्पय उन्नत उज्जल शाम सभक्ति श्रियम हरि पुरट सुंदर दुते संदीपित सदा हृदय स्कंदरे वह स्फुरत सति नंदनतम। तो इस प्रकार के इस श्लोक को देख करके सभी लोग बड़े आनंद से उछल पड़े, बोले बहुत सुंदर बहुत सुंदर। महाप्रभु जी बोले अरे क्या सुंदर किया, ये तो ये अमृत के कलश में ये बिंदु सुरा ऐसे ही ऐसे डाल दिया, ऐसे क्यों किया। तो सभी भक्तों ने बोले कि महाप्रभु प्रभु ये तो अमृत ये अमृत के घड़े में एक बिंद कर्पूर डाल दिए गए और भी सुस्वादु और सुंदर बना दिए। जैसे तो खीर में कर्पूर डालते हैं उसी तरह का और भी सुंदर अमृतमय बन गया है। इस प्रकार से रायानंद जी ने नाटक के पात्र का वर्णन और उसमें पात्री का वर्णन और उनमें दोनों के अनुराग का विषय वर्णन पूर्वराज आदि के सिद्धांत में अब वंशी का वर्णन और इसके साथ में पूर्वराज का वर्णन पूर्वराज के साथ में दोनों के भावों का वर्णन उसके साथ में कैसे मिलन होता है और मिलन में बाधाएं कैसे आती हैं। इस प्रकार के उन बाधाओं में फिर उन लोगों का उत्कम था बढ़ता चला जाता है, अंत में जाकर के मिलन कराते हैं। ये सभी नाटक के विषयों को वर्णन किया। उस समय महाप्रभु जी बड़े प्रसन्न हुए और समस्त वैष्णवों से कहा कि आप सभी लोग इस पर कृपा करें कि ये भक्ति तत्व को रस तत्व को प्रेम तत्व को प्रकाश कर सके। उस समय श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी ने सबसे कृपा भिक्षा की। सभी ने कहा प्रभु जब आपने कृपा कर दी आपके अंतरंग जो भाव को पहचान गए और तब हम लोग उसकी क्या बात है। तो सभी ने महाप्रभु जी ने उनके लिए सबसे कृपा भिक्षा की थी। यही स्थान है जहाँ महाप्रभु जी ने समस्त भक्तों को लेकर के संगोष्ठी किया था। इस प्रकार से चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी ने एक बार से हरिदास ठाकुर जी से पूछा, हरिदास जीवों का उद्धार कैसे होगा। तब उन्होंने जवाब दिया कि प्रभु उत्तर दिया कि प्रभु हरिनाम संकीर्तन के द्वारा। बोले जो हरिनाम कीर्तन नहीं करते उनका कैसे उद्धार होगा, जैसे कि विदर्भी लोग हैं मुस्लिम इत्यादि उनका कैसे उद्धार होगा। तब उन्होंने बताया कि हाँ वे लोग इस स्वर को देख करके हराम हराम करते हैं, इससे उसको नामाभास हो जाता है, इस नामाभास के द्वारा उनका भी उद्धार हो जाएगा। इस प्रकार महाप्रभु जी जो करुणा बता रहे हैं करुणा बढ़ा रहे हैं उनके अपार करुणा नाम प्रेम प्रदान में श्री हरिदास ठाकुर जी प्रधान सहायक के रूप में जो कि हरिनाम के वे आचार्य बने और प्रतिदिन वे 3 लाख हरिनाम जप किया करते थे और इस प्रकार निष्किंचन निष्कपट वैष्णव के रूप में वे यहीं पर अवस्थान किए भजन किया। जबकि उनका शरीर धीरे धीरे ढीला होने लगा, एक दिन तबीयत कुछ खराब होने लगी तो उस समय उन्होंने प्रसाद को मना कर दिया। गोविंद जब की प्रसाद भेजे हैं उन्होंने कहा आज मैं प्रसाद का लंघन करता हूँ, जाने आज प्रसाद ग्रहण नहीं करूंगा क्योंकि मेरा हरिनाम नहीं हो पाया। तो एक दिन उन्होंने महाप्रभु जी से भी प्रार्थना कर ली कि प्रभु मेरी ये प्रार्थना आपको स्वीकार करनी होगी। बोले क्या है बताओ, कि मैं आपके सामने ही चला जाना चाहता हूँ। तो उस समय महाप्रभु जी बोले कि अच्छी बात है, इस बात को मैं स्वीकार करूंगा। तो एक दिन महाप्रभु जी सभी भक्तों को लेकर के आए यहाँ पर बैठे, तब श्री हरिदास ठाकुर जी उनके गोदी में मस्तक रख करके अंत श्वास उपारम उन्होंने परम गति को जो कि महाप्रभु जी में आविष्ट होकर के उस परम धाम की प्राप्ति की। महाप्रभु जी ने उनका नाम कीर्तन करते करते, उनके चरण कमल का ध्यान करते करते, उनके गोदी में ही उन्होंने मस्तक रख करके यही पर परम धाम की प्राप्ति की, जो कि उसके पश्चात महाप्रभु जी समस्त भक्तों के साथ में उन्हें लेकर के जो कि स्वर्ग द्वार में समुद्र के किनारे ले जाकर उनको समाधि दी और सभी के साथ में कीर्तन करते हुए महाप्रभु जी स्वयं आए। जगन्नाथ मंदिर के आनंद बाजार में उन्होंने स्वयं प्रसाद की भिक्षा की, सभी वैष्णवों को भोजन कराए। इस प्रकार श्री हरदास ठाकुर जी के चरणों में हम लोग नमन करते हैं, प्रार्थना करते हैं, वे कृपा करें। जबकि श्री दयानंद जी ने श्री रूप गोस्वामी जी से नाम की महिमा पूछी, तब उन्होंने उस विषय में जो श्लोक लिखा था नाटक में उसका वर्णन किया। तुंडे तांडव निरतिम वितनुते तुंडा बलि लब्धये कर्ण कोण कलम्बिनी घटायते कर्णारुदे प्रस्प्रियां। जो कि ये कृष्ण नाम इतना मधुर है, इतना मधुर से भी परम मधुर, और इतनी उनके अंदर में चेतना है, जबकि इस जीवा में पूरा हरिनाम आ जाता है तो तुंडे तांडवनी रतिम इतने प्रकार से तांडव नृत्य करते हैं जो कि हजारों मुंह जैसे आ जाए और उस मुंह में हरिनाम संकीर्तन होने लगता है। ये हरिनाम साक्षात कृष्ण का स्वरूप है जिसमें पूर्ण चेतना है और उसके साथ में वो विकसित होने लगता है, और जबकि हृदय प्रांगण में आता है तो उस समय स्मरण पटल में आने पर हृदय आनंद से उच्छलित हो जाता है। इस प्रकार से हरिनाम की अद्भुत मधुरिमा है। इन बातों को सुनकर हरदास ठाकुर जी आनंद से उछल कर नाचने गाने लग गए। तो इस प्रकार जो कि श्रील नामाचार्य हरिदास ठाकुर और श्रील रूप गोस्वामी पाद, श्री सनातन गोस्वामी पाद यहीं पर निवास करते थे, आज हम लोग उनकी पावन भूमि में भजन स्थली में हम लोग आए हैं। उनके कृपा अनुग्रह के हम सभी प्रार्थी हैं, वे हम सब पर जितनी दया करें कि हरिनाम की स्फूर्ति हम
Gauranga. This place that we come to is called Siddha Baku, also the Samadhi of Nam Sri Namacharya, Sri Haridas Thakur. And Bhajan Kuti of Sri Haridas Thakur. So, Sri Haridas Thakur was born just on the border of Bangladesh. So Mahaprabhu manifested his independence through the mouth. Sri Brahma, Lord Brahma, after his pastimes in Vrindavan, Brahmaji became a little ashamed. Oh, I made a mistake. I thought that I was so qualified that I could not understand the pastimes of Krishna. So Brahmaji made a vow, if I can take birth in a very low position, then definitely I must get the mercy of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So this way, Sri Namacharya Haridas Thakur is a combined incarnation of both Prahlad Maharaj and Lord Brahma. So Brahma, Prahlad Brahma Haridas Thakur. So from birth, he had great attraction for chanting Harinam. So the pastimes of Sri Haridas Thakur are described, especially in Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat and also Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Described that Sri Haridas Thakur used to move here and there, chanting the holy names. How we chant? 3 lakhs a day. Mahaprabhu gave him as a perfect example. Apana chorekohe no koriya prachar, apana prachara kore no koriya achar. Achar, prachar, nami duikaja, tumi jaga guru, tumi jagatera aja. Mahaprabhu said, O Haridas, some people practice, Some people do bhajan themselves, but never try to help others by teaching them the path of bhajan. Some practice but do not preach. Other people preach but do not practice. Oh, Haridas, you are perfect because you do both. You practice and you preach, therefore you are Jagadguru and you are the best of the Aryans, the best of the topmost persons. So even though Sri Haridas Thakur was born in a Muslim family, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifested his independence by explaining the glories of Yuga Dhamma Nam Sankirtan through the mouth of a Muslim, Sri Haridas Thakur. In the same way, Sri Mahaprabhu manifested Rasa Shastra through the mouth of a Sudra, Sri Ramananda Roy. So Mahaprabhu manifested his pastimes through different devotees, born in all different parts of India. So Sri Haridas Thakur always manifested great nishtha, an attraction for Harinam. Every day he would chant 3 lakh Harinam. That's 192 rounds. 1 lakh he would chant in his mind. 1 lakh he would do japa, that only you can hear. But 1 lakh loudly he would chant Harinam so that everyone could get the benefit. In Sri Harinam Chintamani, Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur describes the conversation between Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sri Namachari Haridas Thakur. So there, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu asked him, "Oh, how one can become delivered in Kali Yuga?" So Sri Haridas Thakur said, "By chanting Harinam." But Mahaprabhu asked, "But what about those jivas who cannot chant?" Then Sri Haridas Thakur said, "Then any Vaishnava who loudly chants Kirtan, then if that Harinam touches them, like trees, birds, creepers and insects, just by the touch of Harinam, they can also be delivered." So Sri Haridas Thakur was not only interested in his own liberation, he was interested in liberating all. In this way he manifested the character of Prahlad Maharaj. See, Prahlad Maharaj said, "I am not interested in my own liberation. I am not like the yogis who go to the Himalayas and selfishly meditate for their own moksha. But I want that all should be liberated." So Sri Haridas Thakur used to move all around, especially Bengal, preaching glories of Harinam. So a Vaishnava has no enemies, isn't it? There are many people who are envious of Sri Haridas Thakur, including one Muslim king and one Qazi. They captured Sri Haridas Thakur. They said, "Oh Haridas, you had such good fortune that you were born in a very elevated Muslim family. But you've thrown all that down the drain and you've taken up to the lower class activity of chanting the name of the Hindu god Krishna. Instead you should chant Ya Allaha Allaha. You should chant the name of Allah. You should give up this thing. If you don't give it up, we will cut you into 1,000 pieces." So Sri Haridas Thakur, he said, "Kalana kalane deha malpran amitukavine shari harinam. You can cut my body to thousands of pieces, but I cannot stop the chanting of Harinam." So the Muslim king ordered Haridas Thakur to be put into jail. So inside the jail were many, many sadhus and brahmins. So when they saw Haridas Thakur, they became very happy. They ran to his feet. "Oh Maharaj, please give us a blessing. We are suffering very much in the jail of the Muslim king." So Sri Haridas Thakur gave blessing. "May you remain as you are." So all the sadhus thought, "What type of blessing is this?" They became very sad. Sri Haridas Thakur said, "You cannot understand the meanings of my words. Now you are in jail, that means there is no chance for material enjoyment. You are by force separated from your wives and mothers and fathers. Therefore your mind is not attached to them. Right now, you are in Sadhu Sangha, hearing the glories of the holy name. What else is higher than this? Therefore remain as you are." So all the sadhus became very happy. Haridas Thakur gave them many, many instructions. All became very enlightened. So the Muslim king ordered Haridas Thakur to be beaten to death in 22 marketplaces. So the Muslims had very big bloody sticks with iron tips and they were beating the body of Sri Haridas Thakur. But by the mercy of Harinam, Sri Haridas Thakur was so ecstatic, he never felt the beatings on his body. Even though all the flesh was stripped from his back and legs, the bones were broken and poking through, Haridas Thakur was now hands in the air, "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare." Dancing in ecstasy. The Muslims could not understand. "We cannot kill him. In fact, the harder we beat him, the more he is laughing at Haribol. Sometimes he smiles at us. Who is this person?" The Muslims became very sad. O Haridas, if you do not die, then the king will kill us because we failed to execute our responsibilities. So Haridas Thakur, he said, oh, by living I am giving you pain, therefore let me die. So Sri Haridas Thakur did not die because the Vaishnava never dies. He went into Samadhi because Krishna, who is the root cause of millions and millions of universes, was present in the heart of Sri Haridas Thakur. The Muslims could not lift his body because he was in Samadhi. So the Muslim king said, now that Sri Haridas Thakur is dead, don't bury him. Because even Muslims bury their dead. Because if you bury him, he'll go to heaven. But if you throw him in the Ganga, then he'll take birth, then he'll, his life will be useless. So they threw his Sri Vigrahar in the Ganga, but Haridas Thakur floated, came out of the river, his body was completely whole. And he went straight back into the courtyard of the king, Hare Krishna, Jai Ho Maharaj. All the Muslims became astonished. Oh, obviously, he is a perfect Muslim. I called a peer.
Jinda Peer.
Because he is a perfect devotee of Allah, therefore, Jai Ho Maharaj, whatever you want to do, you can do. So Sri Haridas Thakur manifested that type of Nishtha and Harinam. Sometimes we think, oh, we have come to bhajan, many problems coming. Guru Maharaj says sometimes we worship a little baby gopa, we worship the deity of Krishna. When our desires are not fulfilled or some problem comes, we take the deity and throw him in the Ganga. But Sri Haridas Thakur manifested, even though he was a perfect devotee, many, many problems came to him, but he never gave up his Hari Bhajan. So his life is full of millions of teachings. So Guru Maharaj one time said, Sri Bhavanaj also one time said, 16 rounds means subhuman, not human platform. 32 rounds means human platform. 64 rounds means has interest in devotional service. The Guru Maharaj says, one day, why marvel my Namachari Haridas Thakur, Guru of Harinam? Because one day you also have to try to chant that type of Harinam, 3 lakh a day. So 3 lakh Hari day, 3 lakh of Harinam every day takes like 23 hours. So our Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he also followed in the footsteps of Sri Haridas Thakur by chanting that type of Harinam. That's why his preaching was so successful. So also, Sri Haridas Thakur, 192 runs. Sri Haridas Thakur used to come here and do bhajan. Even though he was very pure Vaishnava, qualified, head of our Sampradaya, because he is Brahmaji, he would not go inside the temple of Jagannath. Because don't challenge Jagannath, like Guru Maharaj was saying yesterday. So he would sit here and look at the chakra. But his pure, his devotion was so pure, every day Lord Jagannath, say Krishna, say God, say Jagannath, every day Lord Jagannath in the form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu would come here and provide him with his own hands to Mahaprasad. So Mahaprabhu felt very sad. Oh, Haridas Thakur is sitting here in a hot sun chanting Harinam. He has no bodily sense. Therefore, Mahaprabhu took one toothstick, toothbrush. Sometimes you see in India, they use a toothbrush, and I have a twig. So he took that prasadi remnants from Lord Jagannath and stuck here. And in one night, this huge bakul tree came. And Haridas Sri Haridas Thakur used to chant underneath this tree. One day, they were trying to make him Ratha Yatra many years after. So they came to cut the Siddha bakul. So all the Vaishnavas felt very sad. Oh, in fact, this is the remembrance, the chanting place of Sri Haridas Thakur. Also, Sri Rupa, Sri Sanatana Goswami, Sri Ramananda Roy, Sri Sarup Damodar had many, many, many pastimes here. And this tree is a witness. Therefore, they prayed to the Lord, if this tree is cut, it's a great loss for us. So what happened? A miracle. Next day, they came to cut the tree, but they saw the center of the tree had become completely, like, rotten. Nothing was there. But the tree is still growing. Now this tree is more than 500 years old. So they're called Siddha Bakul. So many pastimes here with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and especially with Sri Rupa Goswami. One day Sri Mahaprabhu asked to Sri Rupa Goswami, O Rupa Goswami, Sri Rupa, can you describe the glories of Harinam? So Sri Rupa Goswami wrote one verse, I'll try and remember it. Tunde Kundamani Batin Tundani Labdaya Kana Krava Kandamati Kataya Kamepriya Sriyam Chetam Pangano Vijayate Kavitriya Sriyam Kiyam Risa Vyati Krishna Devana. Okay, Rupa Goswami said, oh, I cannot describe the sweetness. Madhura Madhuram Neta Mangala Mangalanam. Of all sweet things, the name of Krishna is the sweetest. Therefore, when I chant, I wish I had millions of tongues. Of all sweet things to hear, Krishna's name is the sweetest. I wish I had millions of ears. When I hear the name of Krishna, all my senses become inert. The mind, the intelligence, all our panchindriya, all become completely drowned in nectar. Paramijaya, saratma snapanam paramijaya, Sri Krishna sankirtanam. So all my senses become drowned in nectar. I cannot work. And Harinam, which is Radha and Krishna themselves, dance in the courtyard of my heart. He said, I try to measure, but it's impossible how much nectar is in those two syllables, Krishna. So when Sri Haridas Thakur, who is the guru of Harinam, when he heard that, he began to dance like a madman. Oh, this is the glories of Harinam. This is the glories of Harinam. So we've come to this place. We are wretched and fallen. We have no nothing.
So,
when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would perform Ratha Yatra, again and again he would be chanting one verse. So Rupa Goswami wrote one parallel verse here in this place, and he put on the roof, on the thatch, for the ink to dry, he put there. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, and he thought, what is this? He pulled that slope from the roof of Haridas Thakur's cottage. He read that, oh, how did you know my heart? And like in a joking manner, he beat Sri Rupa Goswami. So Sri Damodara said, how did he know your heart? It must be he has gotten your mercy, otherwise no one can understand your heart. So here also Sri Rupa Goswami read out his dramas. Brahmananda Roy read out his dramas, but he'd written two dramas. Satyabhama Devi appeared before Rupa Goswami in a vision. Don't make one drama, you should keep Dwarka pastimes and the pastimes of Vrindavan separate. So here Sri Ramananda Roy read out the drama of Sri Rupa Goswami. Sri Rupa Goswami wrote, what is the Mandala Charanam? Rupa Goswami was shy, he would not say. Mahaprabhu asked again and again, then, Anapita Chirim Chira Kuruna Yavataro Kalok Samarapaya Kamanucha Ravasam Sarati Sriyam Hari Purita Sundara Dutti Kandava Sandara Pitsari Guruti Spuriti Vaha Sri Sachi Nandana. That means, I give my obeisances to the feet of that Sachi Nandana. May he appear in everybody's heart. Because Sri Rupa Goswami is not selfish. He never said, Mahaprabhu should only appear in my heart. I wish that Gauranga Mahaprabhu, whose complexion is like a golden kadamba tree, who appeared after a very, very long time to give, which no other incarnation has given, the service of Srimati Radhika in the mood of Manjaris. So when Mahaprabhu heard that, because Mahaprabhu is acharya, showing no one likes to hear their own glory sung, one who glorifies himself drinks poison at every step, Mahaprabhu said, what have you done? This drama is like a pot of nectar, and you will put one drop of poison by glorifying me. So that's how Sri Damodara said. No. Sri Ramananda Roy said, no, he has not put one drop of poison, he has put one drop of camphor. Just like sweet rice. Have you ever had sweet rice with camphor? Then it tastes very wonderful. So many, many pastimes are here. Unconditioned soul, how much can we say? So we just pray to the feet of Sri Namacharya Haridas Thakur. He can bless us, remove all our aparads, our anatas, our unwillingness to chant the name of Krishna. If we can get his mercy, one more thing. He also, Sri Haridas Thakur examined his nista right to the end of his life. Sri Gauranga Dev came here. Sri Haridas Thakur was lying down in a prone position. Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu asked, Haridas, are you sick? So Haridas Thakur said, no Lord, my mind and body are okay, but I have one disease, I cannot finish my chanting of Harinam. So those who have taken initiation must chant at least 32 rounds, minimum. And of course those who like bhajan can try and chant 64, but every day, have to do nista, I'm not doing so, how can I say? Sri Haridas Thakur manifested this. Mahaprabhu said, oh Haridas, you are already perfect. So you can lessen your chanting of Harinam, no problem. So Haridas Thakur said, Lord, I have one request. I think that soon you will finish your pastimes in this world. I don't want to be present when you are not here. I don't want to experience that separation. So I wish that I should leave before you. Because if one insect dies, who will cry for an insect? Say, Haridas Thakur said, Mahaprabhu became very emotional. Oh, Haridas, how you can say like that? But I think Krishna is very merciful. He must have filled your desire. So next day, Mahaprabhu and all his devotees came to this courtyard, and Haridas Thakur was lying there. See, Haridas Thakur went and caught the feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, put them on his chest, and looking at the moon-like face of Gaurahari, he chanted, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, and went to Paramgati, the local Vrindavan. So Mahaprabhu showed how much to respect the Vaishnava. So Mahaprabhu began to glorify Sri Haridas Thakur like he had five mouths, like another shesh. He took the Sri Vigraha of Sri Haridas Thakur in his arms and personally began to dance and chant here in this courtyard. Then Mahaprabhu went and, I guess, bathed the body of Haridas, Sri Haridas Thakur in the ocean. From that day on, this Indian Ocean, the Bay of Bengal, has become Mahatirtha. By the touch of the foot dust of Sri Haridas Thakur, Mahaprabhu gave, with his own hands, they dug the samadhi in the sands of Puri. All the Vaishnavas put one handful of sand, and Mahaprabhu with his own hands went to break prasadam of Jagannath for the Viraha Mahotsav festival of Sri Haridas Thakur. So how much beloved Sri Haridas Thakur was to Gauranga Mahaprabhu. If we can attract the mercy of Sri Haridas Thakur, then we know the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu must be right behind us, chasing us. So Pancha Kapatipas Charakrapa Sindhavya Vachara Patitanam Bhavana Vyoga Vachara.
हरे कृष्णा, आप लोग हम इधर से सीधा जगन्नाथ मंदिर जाएंगे. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी विल गो टू श्री जगन्नाथ देव टेम्पल. सो आई रिक्वेस्टिंग ऑल वेस्टर्न डिवोटी शुड नॉट ट्राई टू एंटर इन जगन्नाथ देव टेम्पल. दे कैन टेक दर्शन फ्रॉम आउटसाइड पति पावन श्री जगन्नाथ देव. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी विल गो डायरेक्ट टू जगन्नाथ देव टेम्पल. On the way, we'll go to the place of Sarvam Bhattacharya. All can allow to go there. Because there is no so much place, very little place. But we shall come back immediately from there. We will not sit there because there is no place for sitting. Coming back, we will speak Harikatha in our place in evening time about Sarvam Bhattacharya and others. So from here, we'll go to Sarvam Bhattacharya place, then to Jagannath Dev Temple. Hare Krishna. And every Indian devotee not allowed to take camera, they never allowed to take another temple. Harati Bhaktadi, Jagannathir ka mandir ke andar, camera, they were knowledge and so log lelenga milega nahi. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.